Everyone, Sachin here from ngrok support, and today we're going to be talking about how to set up OAuth using Google with your cloud endpoints. We all know that setting up authentication for your application is hard and often takes more time than actually deploying your services. With ngrok's OAuth traffic policy action, these issues are completely abstracted away from you as a developer, and ngrok allows for you to protect your endpoint and then perform actions based on the metadata of your user, along with taking away all the concern for setting up callback URLs as well as any token exchange. So today I'm going to walk you through how to use ngrok's OAuth traffic policy to protect your cloud endpoints and use the metadata that's provided in this process to enhance your application. So let's get right into it. So right here, I have a cloud endpoint that I've set up. And what this cloud endpoint is doing right now is it's forwarding internally to a Streamlit application that I have running locally on my own machine. And so what we've done here is set up an OAuth traffic policy. So the phase that OAuth traffic policy can occur is on HTTP request. And what we've done here is we've used one of ngrok's managed providers, in this case, Google, in order to supply the authentication flow for this traffic policy. And in this traffic policy, you can see on line 10 here, what I'm doing is I'm making sure that any user that's trying to access my locally running application is logging in with an email that ends with ngrok.com. This is really helpful when you want to share something that you're working on with your coworkers or share something that you've been working on just with a set of users that share the same email domain. And what I'm doing once a user is authenticated is I'm adding headers to the request that gets passed to my upstream service. So here, what we're doing is we're using our OAuth traffic policy action variables of the user's email and the user's name. And you'll see in a bit how we're accessing this in our upstream Streamlit application. And when a user doesn't log in with their ngrok.com email address, we're going to show them a custom HTML page that prompts them to log in with their ngrok email. So now what we're going to do is we're going to see this OAuth flow in action, and we'll be able to see the full authentication flow from a user perspective of what this will look like in production. So we're going to open a new incognito tab for the sake of keeping session cache and cookies clear. We're going to go to our cloud endpoint link, and we're prompted with this login page. So I'm going to log in with my ngrok account, and we're going to go through an authentication flow. And yep, now that we're signing back in ngrok.com, everything looks great. And now we're here. And as you can see, the headers that were sent to the request upon successful authentication are being used in our application to greet our user. This is just one example of how traffic policy and the metadata that ngrok collects when using traffic policy can be used to enhance your upstream application. Thanks so much for listening and take care.